You have enough from sleepless nights, suffering or being afraid. You have enough from feeling the pain of project execution. You are still losing against second-class competitors. The key question is how you can change this. The answer is Metis. Connect perfectly the office with the construction site. Have real-time information at your fingertips. Therefore, you will make based on facts best decisions. Enjoy your free time, stressless, and be the hero in execution of your EPC projects, industrial projects, shutdowns, and piping works. You simplify your plant construction life. Learn more in this video and contact us now. Hello, my name is Franz, and today in this video I'm going to show you how isometric management and bunch list works in Metis. So we are already here in a demo project, and first I would like to show you here under calculation piping that everything is empty. The entire project, also here under isometric material request, is empty. Also here under isometric management, nothing there. And this we will change now. As a first step, let's say I will enter a price list for parts, and I will import this here in order to be faster. There are just for some pipes whatsoever here. Now we go to line list, and as a first step I import the line list because this is the basis for the isometric management. And as a next step, I import already some isometrics before I'm going then in detail to show you how it works. So now we have the main parts there, and we start with the line list management. So of course you can create here any line which you want. You have several information that you can give in, or like me, you can just simply import it. Or you can delete it, and here's a revision control, which I will show you then under isometric management, because we can see much better there. Here are all of the data that are usual for a line list, and yeah, this is what is there. You cannot do so much with the line list, it's more for information, but yes, it's the basis for here. Nevertheless, some fields are here linked with others, for example like NDD. This is linked with the welding part. Look at my video for welding management in Metis and you will see that this information will be shown for the welds, how much you should test by isometric. Now we are going to isometric management. In isometric management I can do now several things. First, of course, I can create all of my isometrics. The data here which have these gray cells are coming from some wells. As we already have inserted isometrics, I will use one of them, and I can here see the data, how much it is of different things. And what I can do is I can here upload any files that I want. Doesn't matter, I will upload now a list, and this will stay then here, and I have all of my drawings here. Of course I can also upload pictures and different kind of things. Here is a work history, and the work history, first I need to make a team, because here I can trace the works, the status, let's say, of each isometric. For example, now when I go back here, I can say that, for example, team 1 that we have just added today, I could also say the team member, but let's say today starts with the working map done. And it will stay here. This is also one way of progress measurement for isometrics. There's another way which I'm going to show you also, but this is one way. And here I can add more. If I have different themes, of course, I can add different themes. And here, these progress steps, you can individually adjust for each project. It's not given like here, it's a standard, but if you want to change it, no problem, you can change it. And let's say here, let's say this isometric is already done, 100%. Furthermore, you have here a section of spools. And I can say here, we have spool A. Let's say we have only spool A here. And the information will stay like this. Isometric revision I will show you. Here, I have imported you already the parts. I have imported the isometric already with the part list, and I see here how much I have from everything. And maybe you remember a little bit these figures here with 5, 20, whatever. I see here also how much of this I have on stock and how much is missing. So for the moment, I have nothing in stock. Everything is missing. And yeah, we'll do here something. Here, this is then a PDF for material requests. In the same time, when you have isometrics in the material management project parts, it will also put all the parts. It will sum up from all the isometric the quantities. See, here we have, for example, 100. In one isometric, we had 20, which we looked before. And here we have 100. So it sums up from all isometrics. And I'm going to show you this also now. What happens when I do a revision here? For the moment, nothing on stop, nothing procured for the moment. Anyhow, there's a separate video also about material management, how it works. And going back to isometrics. Oh, no, let's look first here under calculation. Before it was empty, now you see here all the isometrics and already with a price calculated. And here are all the details. See, we have this pipe, 20, and with 20 quantity. And it tells already how much is finished. This I can enter here. This is the second method for a project progress calculation. And I give here in, let's say, 15%. And here also only here 15%. That's all, in order to see the difference then in the progress. Here I can choose which company have executed it. For the moment, I have just one company there, but if I have a subcontractor, I can choose here the subcontractor, and it will make the calculation also for the subcontractor. How calculation works, I will explain in a different video, but you can do your calculation and the calculation for your subcontractors in the same time. Important for you here for this video is, when we have an isometric with part list, and if we have prices related to it, the calculation, the build calculation, will be automatically done. From this point of view, you always know how much are your isometric worth. It's not only isometric. I showed in the drawing management for steel structure equipments and so on, and it's the same there. But you know from the beginning, when you have isometrics, drawings, whatsoever, always how much you are going to charge potentially in the end. There's also a progress section, which of course I will also explain in more different details in a different section, in a different video. But when we look here under progress, here the different charts, but in calculation, I have here the same. And see, I have here already a progress value, because I said the isometric is some percentage in the work history and calculates automatic, and I said a percentage here and calculation. Therefore, here, for example, we said 100%, it's 100% from the work value, because progress is on the work value. And here it's a smaller value, because we just said 15% the piping is done and the other parts not. So this is the two ways how a progress control can be done for piping, but also for all other chapters. Now coming back to isometric management, what happens when we import a revision? And I will import now a revision for these isometrics. You see here revision number changed. The last revision will be always shown in the front. It's not necessary to import, you can also make manually, and here's the revision control. You can add here simple revision and will be the same. But the interesting thing is the old status will be kept. See, this is the old status before the revision was coming and will be kept, even the drawings, the status, everything will be kept there. Also the part list, which was there, will be kept. Remember, this is the old part list. Now we are going to show to the new part list and let's see how the new revision looks like. For example, here, see this pipe A, and I wrote it like this to be better visible, was going to zero. So this means actually it doesn't exist in the new revision anymore, but it stays still with zero quantity here in order to remember that it was. And here in the end, we have the old quantities for each revision. Revision number one was on this date and had this quantity. Here in front, or here, it shows the last quantity, because now the calculation which I showed you before will be updated. And you have the new value for this isometric already. Actually, the updates happens every 30 minutes. This is how the software is for the moment designed. Can be also different interval, but 30 minutes is fine in order to keep also the speed of the application quite fast. In addition, we had before looked in the material management and in the project parts. And of course, also here, the required project parts are changing. Before, I think we had 100 as quantity. Now we have 2080 because it was coming 1920 on top. And so from this point of view, when you always have the latest revision, then you also know how much quantity you need for the entire project and if you have enough procured or not. And what I'm going to show you here also, is how you can request material. Let's say, because in order to be able to take over material from the warehouse, you need to have something on stock. And we will say that we have here on stock. And we give here already in the heat number, the certificate number, if you want, the quantity, how much, let's say we received 100, the manufacturer, if we want. And if you want, we can also upload here already the certificate for each part, for each heat number, because this here is linked also with the welding dock. In the welding dock, depend on the takeover of the material related to an isometric, you can choose then already the proper heat number. And this means you have a full traceability from receiving material until installing it in the field. This I show you in the welding section, in the welding video of Metis. Now, when we have something on stock, some isometrics, when we go here, I think I have added here material of this first pipe. Here is the part list of it. You see here how much you have on stock and how much is missing on stock. And so we have 100 from this on stock, and therefore we will request some material. We will say here 100 because I cannot request more than I have available on stock. I make here a material request. It gives me again, I could change here the quantity. I could change here the quantity, and I will make a material request. In the warehouse, now in the under material management, I receive these requests and I can pick it up and see it gives me here the heat number. If I have several heat number, it will give me several lines, and I can now choose who have picked it up when, and then this material was picked up for this isometric. Of course, here I keep then I have to put it in Archivite so that I have just the last on form, and here of course I have then the protocols. I can print out already before protocol to go to the warehouse, and here under teams, for example, it shows me always which team have picked up on which request which material. So this is now the main chapters for isometric management, and close to it is also the spool management, which I'm going to show you now. In addition to this, we entered here a spool A, and so it comes also here under spool management. And here in the spool management, for example, I could say on a phased way, what is my status of this spool? Moreover, under isometrics, I can give in some additional information for this spool. When I open this here and I go again to spool management, I can say, for example, where is the storage place? Where I have stored it? Who picked it up? Who stored it? I see here also somehow the status, which we made before, in order so that you don't waste time in searching for spools. And you have here a quite good spool management. This was now the video related to line list, isometric management, and spool management in Metis. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please watch also my other videos and contact me in order to see how I can help you. I wish you a very nice day.
Hello, this is Franz again. I hope you liked the video. But most important is what you really need, what brings you and your business forward. Therefore, contact me now and we will cost-free analyze what you really need. See you soon and a lot of successful projects. You simplify your plant construction life.